Down too if it's right.
Right, yeah, you'll get to know.
Okay.
Just remember, you're always playing that same shape in your left hand that you would be if you were doing regular lead guitar stuff, like you've done from the beginning. We're just adding a right hand to it. So in that first position, we're playing the notes that are on the top of the second position. All you have to remember is, when you play this, the right hand goes 10, 10, then 9, 10, 10, 10. So there's only one string that's off. Third string is 9. Then it goes back to 10, 10, back to 10. So over here, this will happen fairly naturally because it's what you're used to doing. So it's all 10, 10, 9, 10, 10, 10. That one, when you're playing first position, the one string that's off is the third string. It's down a fret.
Okay.
10, 10, 9, 10, 10, 10. We're playing the key of A. So now we move up to the second position in your left hand. All you have to remember, now you're playing the notes from the third position. That's where we got them. But all you have to remember is that your right hand just goes 12, then it moves up to the 13, then it's all back to 12. So on the first string, here's your scale again, your left hand. It's the same as you always do. That should be fairly normal. That should be fairly intuitive at this point. When you add to that, remember we're doing a tap, pull, hammer, tap, pull, pull. Always lead with this one pattern we're doing this week. Just lead with your pointer finger. Put that pointer finger down. Okay, so you're going to go. The second string goes up a fret. Now here's the notes in the left hand, like always. You go back to the 12th fret. Here's the notes as always, stay on the 12th fret. Notes as always, stay on the 12th fret. Notes as always, stay on the 12th fret. Cool. So it's just this with 12, and the only one that's different is the second string goes up to 13. The other one that we're going to do, just to give you the rest of the fretboard, we're going to skip the next one, the third position. We're going to go right to the fourth position, because that's a little more common. So it's that same old, you know, fourth position that you know. And this one's really easy. We're going to be tapping the notes out of the fifth position, which is the same as the bottom of the first position. It's the same as these, so it's just all the 17th fret.
Yeah.
It's all the same fret, yeah, 5th fret above the double dots. So you're doing this. So you're going to be going. So really all you have to be thinking in this one, you don't even have to think about the right hand at all.
Yeah.
Just keep it there and get that. Whatever fingerings you like, you know, some people will do ring and pointer for all of it. That's a particularly comfortable one for this position. Top fret here. You can do the same thing up an octave. Now you get the entire fretboard to work with.
Okay.
Get that one pattern this week, that's all.
Okay.
And then what we'll do next time is we'll eventually add those other pattern positions in, but they're not as important. You've got a good run of the fretboard here. You know, you have everything from here, you know, you can go up to here, and then you've got this little section in between, and then you go back to the first position.
Okay.
So you're covering basically all the fretboard. And using the most important positions that you already know from soloing. And what we'll do is we'll just do some different types of patterns. So instead of going, we'll do things like. These are just a little different movement pattern. Basically, that's even simpler. It's just this one. Going back and forth. We'll start doing some things like that.
Okay.
We'll do some ascending runs like. You get like a, or maybe like just running straight down the scale. We need maybe 4, maybe 5 patterns, and you can start to mix them.
Okay.
The key right now is to get this. Cool. can get all those, you're set.
Okay.